And now to our NewsHour Shares. Seawalls help to protect shorelines, but they can also destroy crucial habitat. One project in Washington state aims to fix that. Ken Christensen of KCTS's Earth Fix explains.
The Seattle waterfront is changing right beneath your feet.
When you walk along Seattle's sidewalk, you'll be walking on glass panels.
But look deeper, and you'll see that the changes aren't for tourists. They're for natives.
Their function is to provide light to help thousands and thousands of little baby salmon.
It's one feature of Seattle's new seawall, a $400 million infrastructure project that's doubling as a really big science experiment, the biggest of Jeff Cordell's career.
I mean, nothing has ever been tried on this scale. You're walking on foot after foot after foot of new habitat.
Cordell wants to see if coastal cities can better coexist with fish. For 80 years, Seattle's seawall was like most, a flat concrete slab that held back the sea but destroyed shallow water habitat that many species thrive on. Every spring, young salmon would migrate from Seattle's Duwamish River to the ocean, and they're hardwired to stay close to shore, which means they run right into this. In the inky darkness under the pier, life can get confusing for a fish.
There's a good example of a shadow line from a pier, and they don't want to cross the shadow line, so they just mill around here.
The new seawall is supposed to make life easier, not only by providing a naturally lit corridor for the fish to pass through on their way to the ocean, but also by featuring overhangs and rocky surfaces along the way for fish food to grow on.
Look at the brown scum here. We love to see that because that's where the little crustaceans grow that the juvenile salmon feed on. You can't count out brown scum.
Most seawalls are still built like Seattle's was back in the 1930s, and construction is expected to increase.
There's going to be much more need for coastal infrastructure and a lot more thinking about how we can best create habitat for organisms that we're removing it from.
Once the seawall is complete, Cordell plans to begin a decade-long monitoring project to figure out if it does what it's supposed to.
Even that brown stuff needs a good amount of sunlight to grow.
If the experiment succeeds, the Seattle waterfront's biggest change could be the change it inspires in seawalls around the world. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Ken Christensen in Seattle, Washington.